So first, let's look at what is digital trust. So put simply, digital trust is relying on a trusted third party to vouch for a digital identity used online to provide you with assurance that the person, business, or service using the identity is who they claim to be. In the physical world, you can easily verify the existence of a business because you can visit their premises, you can meet, greet, and talk to company representatives, and in most cases, pay for and walk away with your purchase. However, in the digital world, that's not possible. You can't visit a physical place of business, which makes it super easy for a digital business to be created that might look like a reputable brand, but instead it's being used for fraudulent activities. And in the digital world, you can't rely on the visual inspection of a digital storefront. You know, those are created by fraudsters to look exactly like a real brand, to fool you and I into parting with money, or more importantly, our personal information for them to pretend to be you to create further purchases. So this is where the trust service provider, or TSP, comes into play. We'll discuss different types of trust service providers shortly, but essentially all of these providers have an important function to play. They have to perform verification checks to unequivocally identify the business, the person, and in some cases the application they're about to issue a digital identity to. We'll discuss the different types of identities used in further Ascertia sessions, but without proving the identity, you are not able to deliver trust. Technically, there's three types of trust service provider that you would normally encounter. So they all issue digital certificates from software products. And when you look at the dictionary definition of what is a public key infrastructure, you kind of boil this down to a set of roles, policies, hardware, software, and procedures. And if I kind of extrapolate that and think about it, PKI is 80% policy procedure, and probably 20% software. Many people can install a product without any processes, procedures, and issue certificates. And that's not really considered PKI, it's a certificate pump. What makes a real PKI and a trust service provider is installing software to comply with a set of roles, policies, procedures that help you meet certain legal and legislative frameworks. So the first type of trust service provider that you would encounter is there to help secure online e-commerce. So you may have heard of extended validation TLS certificates, or EV as they're shortened to. You have DV, domain validated, or OV, organization validated. And these are issued to web servers on the internet that support online banking, online shopping, and help to secure the connection between your internet browser or an app on your mobile device and the retailer, the bank, the service provider where you're exchanging sensitive information. So you could be applying for a loyalty card, you could be accessing online banking, you could be buying something from an online trader, and your credit card information, your personal information needs to be secured from when you type it into your browser to the backend provider. Now, that's one element. And the second element is you need to know when you're accessing these service providers that they're secure and the identity of the retailer, the bank you're connected with, is authentic. So this is where a few years ago, the address bar in the browser turned green for extended validation. Some of this stuff has fallen away. But that's the first type of trust service provider, is the issue of these credentials to organizations and their services that prove who they are and secure information from your browser to the backend service. And there, that type of PKI is a publicly trusted one, and it's publicly trusted in that it's the certificates that underpin it, its certification authorities, they're embedded within your device. So they're in your Windows machine, your Apple laptop, your Linux machine, and they're there because they comply with the CA browser forum baseline requirements, and they outline how that PKI should be run, how it should be operated, et cetera. And they also need to meet the root program requirements that Microsoft, Apple, and others have. So there's a whole legislative and more policy framework that must exist for that type of trust service provider to be established and operated, and importantly, audited. There's got to be somebody, a third party, that says, show me your policies and procedures. Do you meet them? Yes, no. And we award you with a certificate to say you're meeting the requirements and you're free to operate for 12 months, and then you're re-audited. So there's lots of big audit firms that provide that to TLS providers. The second type of trust service provider you would encounter, and I guess the second and third one kind of almost blend into the same category because they're all around issuing credentials to sign documents. So the first one would be the Adobe Approved Trustless Program, or more formally known as AATL, or commonly known as AATL for short. And they have, Adobe lays down its technical requirements that CAs must meet in order to participate in that program. Similar to the CA browser forum, you know, you're audited, those policies and procedures must exist, you're checked on a regular basis, and in meeting those requirements, your CA certificates are embedded within a trust list that the Adobe Reader application, and obviously other PDF reading applications, but primarily Adobe, will download and have stored locally. So anywhere in the world, a PDF, when a PDF's opened, that's signed with a certificate from one of these approved trust lists or approved vendors, that signature is automatically trusted by Adobe. So, you know, these AATL providers are certification authorities that are built, operated, and audited to the AATL technical requirements, which means a signature on any document that Adobe opens is automatically trusted. And that's quite a powerful thing when you think about the ability to say, I'm going to create a document, I'm going to sign it, and it's going to be verifiable and trusted anywhere in the world, which is great. You can prove the authenticity of the document. The third provider that I kind of reference in the signature space is a qualified trust service provider. And a qualified trust service provider category is there to guarantee or to issue certificates to people, organizational roles, and organizations that meet the European Union digital signature legislation. And that means that if you sign a document using a certificate from a qualified trust service provider, it's automatically trusted and accepted throughout the European Union as with as much legal standing as a traditional wet or physical signature. So similar in nature to AATL, you're audited on an annual basis. There are a set of regulatory requirements that you must meet. You must have policies and procedures, but the result is a credential that's issued. It is automatically trusted by a reading application, but there is a legal weighting to a qualified digital signature. So whilst the two signing trust service providers are very similar in nature, one provides you with a signature that's automatically trusted and verified when you open a piece of software. The other, the qualified one, gives you the ability to have the signature trusted, but also with a legal weighting to it as well, meaning you can sign contracts, you can enter into legal agreements, you can transact, you can buy property, etc., etc. Trust service providers have a number of choices when they want to establish themselves. So lots of providers often have a variety of skills at their disposal. There'll be software architects, policy and administration consultants. You've got to build the policy and frameworks that your trust service provider needs to operate under. But you've also got the concept or the quandary of, do I build the solution myself using software developers? Do I buy in commercial off-the-shelf products? Do I partner with people? And build by partner has been a long-standing question that vendors, service providers often ask themselves. And I guess there's no wrong or right answer depending upon where you sit. If you have an army of software developers at your disposal, then sure, building software that you're going to operate in a trust center might be the right answer for you. But to me, when I kind of take a step back and think about the audit that you have to undertake, you have to prove that your software that you're using to operate as a TSP is trustworthy. It's got to meet a variety of requirements. So ETSI SEN in terms of QTSPs, the Adobe technical requirements, and maybe the CA baseline forum requirements, there's a lot of standards that your software developers must be familiar with. And in a lot of cases, when building products that need to operate to those requirements, being a software developer isn't necessarily enough. You've got to have crypto expertise. You've got to have people that understand the subject matter to a great depth. And so building software at that point becomes less and less attractive because the people that understand and have PKI skills are quite scarce. There's a growing demand for PKI expertise globally. And so you then enter into the discussion of buying commercially off-the-shelf products that are being built by independent software vendors that have expertise in this space, and there's not too many of those on the face of the planet, but they nevertheless are able to attract and retain PKI expertise in building software and delivering complicated technical solutions. So your vendor and that off-the-shelf product is then put through different certification schemes to prove that it's trustworthy. So common criteria being one of those, FIPS being another, which gives you independent assurance that the software that's been built meets the technical requirements and can be proved trustworthy when you're taking it through audit. So when you have this build or buy conversation internally, it's not just a case of, okay, we have an army of developers, let's go and build the software we need. You've got to enter into the thought process of, we can build the software, it must technically meet the requirements, it must be able to undergo the external third-party scrutiny, and for that to be maintained. All of those, when you put them together, can be very time-consuming and a lot more costly than you might first imagine, which makes buying in commercial off-the-shelf products a far more attractive option, because you're looking to a independent provider who has all of the skills and expertise to build the software that are going to meet the certification requirements and then support you long-term. So Ascertia has been around for 20 years plus now in the world of creating products that enable trust service providers, three varieties we've talked about in this session. You know, we build certification authorities, we build products that verify certificate validity, we build products that enable you to digitally sign and verify a signature on a document. And those can be deployed in a variety of use cases. So we've probably got the broadest support for use cases as any vendor I can think of, you know, deploying products in a cloud environment, deploying products on premises within your data centers, or a hybrid where you're deploying a product in your data center that's going to talk to a cloud service. And in being unique in the ability to do that, Ascertia products are more commonly used by trust service providers because we have a long-standing history in building and deploying these solutions. We've taken our solutions through certification processes on a number of occasions. And so really our products are largely built to service the trust service use case. So deploying our CA, deploying our OCSP, our timestamp authority into the trust service provider arena, where you can operate as an Adobe approved trust list member, you can operate as a qualified trust service provider, or you can be a TLS provider issuing TLS and code signing certificates. Our products are built to enable all of those use cases, as well as, you know, entertaining a government national ID or maybe an enterprise PKI use case. Then you can layer on top of that a business application that's going to use those underlying infrastructures to issue certificates to people, devices, and things, to then flow a document from one user to another, register them, apply a digital signature, perform notifications. So Signing Hub is uniquely placed to talk to ADSS Server, our trust services product, to very easily facilitate the workflowing of documents between business users inside of an organization, or for a trust service provider to host Signing Hub built on top of ADSS Server to very easily collect Adobe Advanced digital signatures or even qualified signatures. And then couple that with Ascertia's WebRA server, you kind of have everything you need to be able to enroll, vet, verify a user, make sure that they are who they claim to be, issue their signing credential from a remote qualified signature creation device or locally onto a smart card that will enable them to very quickly be able to sign. So all of these products can be operated, as I say, from a number of different viewpoints, enterprise, government, or trust service provider, and are very commonly found being delivered by TSPs and QTSPs the world over to deliver the all-important use case and digitally signed and trusted documents.